Hi everyone, this is the second mini lecture in chapter 10. This one is on interactions between drug and microbe. So what is the goal of antimicrobial drugs? We want our antimicrobial drugs to either disrupt cell processes or structure of the bacteria, fungi, or protozoa. We want them to inhibit virus replication. Another way that they could work is to interfere with the function of enzymes required to synthesize or assemble macromolecules. This would prevent the microbe from building new cells, destroy structures already formed in the cell. So if we have a cell, perhaps a bacteria that has infected us, this would destroy structures in the already formed cell. And we really want what is called selectively toxic. We want our antimicrobial drugs to kill or inhibit the microorganism in some way, but not to affect the host cell. So some of the drugs that we are currently using, for example, they can exhibit excellent selective toxicity. Those might be ones that would block the synthesis of the bacterial cell wall. So you can imagine in a human body, this would have selective toxicity since we do not have cell walls in our cells. Human cells lack that peptidoglycan, and so they're not affected by the drug. Drugs can be toxic to humans, though, some of the ones that are antimicrobials. And those would be drugs that would act upon structures that we have in common with the infective agent. For example, it might be a cell membrane. Our cells have cell membranes, and so would the infective agent. So if the drug worked on cell membrane, it could be a negative or toxic effect on us. So the more similar that the infectious agent is to the cells of the host, the less selectivity there is for that drug, and so there's more likely to be damage to the host cell as well as to the microbe. So how do the drugs work? We've already talked about that the goal of chemotherapy is finding some structural or metabolic needs of the infectious agent and either removing or disrupting or interfering with the requirement there. So many of the antimicrobial drugs will fall into one of these categories. They may inhibit cell wall synthesis, so the building of the cell wall. They could inhibit nucleic acid structure and function, so DNA or RNA structure and function. They could inhibit protein synthesis, which remember occurs at the ribosome. They could somehow inhibit that transfer of genetic material into protein synthesis. They might interfere with cell membrane structure or the function of that cell membrane. And then also they may inhibit folic acid synthesis, which can be very damaging to a microbe. This is a diagram from your book, and it shows the different sites of action of antimicrobial drugs on bacterial cells. You'll see that we have some that affect protein synthesis at the ribosome. You also have folic acid synthesis that would occur in the cytoplasm, cell wall inhibitors up here, cell membrane, and then lastly, DNA or RNA. So the nucleic acids, they may block at some point in there. So that has a nice view of the different targets. And then the last part of this lecture is going to be a table. This is table 10.4 from the book. And this shows different drugs, what classification they are and what they target. So for example, up here we have drugs that target the cell wall. Basically what I'd like you to know here is the major classes of drugs that target each of those metabolic targets. For example, we have drugs that target the cell wall, and those would include penicillin, cephalosporins, and so on down here. Now remember, if it's the cell wall, this is going to have very good selectivity since we do not have cell walls. There are also drugs then that target protein synthesis. And on our second page of this, drugs that target the protein synthesis. Again, this is a continuation of that. Drugs that would target folic acid synthesis. Drugs that target the nucleic acids. And lastly, drugs that target cell membranes. So on this, mainly what I want you to get from this, once again, is the targets and then which class of drugs target those specific mechanisms. Okay, this is the end of the second lecture. I will have at least one more for this chapter, and hopefully this helped.